For much of the Dark Crusade, great fleets plied the orbital lanes above the battlefields of Cronus, using their firepower to ground long-range flights. Guardsmen and heretic alike had to fight meter by bloody meter, with great battle fleets exchanging fire across the skies. Trench warfare seemed an immutable fact of life for commanders on the ground. All this changed with the Battle of Pavonis. This spaceport featured an ancient Adeptus Mechanicus tracking system merged with the alien technologies of the Tau Aircast. This system was sensitive enough to plot courses that avoided orbital fire, making strikes deep into enemy territory possible. A tech priest had discovered this technological marvel and left his servitors to examine it in detail. Whichever force was able to recover, these bionic servants would gain control of the station and be able to launch strikes across Cronus. Although the local workers never realized it, the mines of Cronus's Hyperion Peaks featured powerful ore-refining machines left there by the tech priests of Mars. These ancient ore processing and field manufacturing plants took on a more martial aspect during the Dark Crusade. Indeed, these same devices could, with relative ease, be made to produce military structures or the processed materials needed to assemble them in the field. those in control of this facility, thus gained the ability to rapidly build forward bases as they pushed across Cronus. The peaks were a difficult battlefield, however. Isolated from standard supply lines, those trying to take the mines were forced to send in a single armored column, ordered to wipe out all enemy structures. Without reinforcements, the tank commanders were on their own.
Thank you.
It was during the Horus Heresy that the influence of Chaos first drove Space Marine against Space Marine. Cronus witnessed some of this terrible fighting, and the heretics of those ancient times left behind them terrible artifacts. In the desolate Ares Badlands stood one such talisman, an ancient icon of the blood god Khorne. With war sweeping Cronus once more, a demon within the icon awoke. It fed on the souls of those slain in combat, and promised gifts to whoever would slake its thirst for blood. Even the warriors of the Imperium ended up feeding the fiend as they fought across the Badlands to prevent others from claiming this prize. The faithful tried to ignore the whispers the demon slipped into their minds, but every death still fed its dark appetite. In the end, whoever controlled the Ares Badlands would gain a measure of the demon's fury, allowing them to launch attack after attack against their enemies.